What's going on, everybody? Welcome to episode 17 of our Atalanta career mode. And today, we got ourselves a bit of a transfer special. It is just going to be transfers today. We are going to go through the deadline. We have a lot of money. £60 million here, £258,000 a week to spend. And we have a variety of different options we can really go through in terms of what to bring in, what to, you know, what to deal with, that sort of stuff. We may get some bids on the final day. A lot. There is a lot here that we can really, really do. So, when we take a look at the squad, I'm thinking, or we were thinking, left back, possibly a winger, and then midfield. I think we're good on center back for the moment, and unless a bid comes in for Zapata, we're good on striker also. But to get a left back in, and to possibly another winger, or someone who can play cam as well, considering we only have Atarin after Gomez left, it's a lot. So what we're going to do is we're going to jump forward to deadline day. I was kind of just waiting to see if any more scout reports came in. I'm actually going to turn this a little bit. Let's help you guys out a little bit there, and there we go. We are not exiting the career. We're going to take a look at our office there, and we've got the final scout reports on one player, unfortunately. And we've also got our opponent, let's see, for the semifinal of the Copa, and it is Torino, so that's probably about as good as we could have had. It's two-legged, so not too bad there, Torino being the one we drawn up. So, Sportiello, upset. Still has his place in the squad, but he probably won't be here next year. And let's go to the transfer hub and spend a little bit of money. So we're going to buy a player here, I think. And this one is more of a future one. This is Alexander Nubel, Schalke goalkeeper. This is someone I want. We're just going to approach to sign him, of course. He is going to be a free. I don't do free transfers very often at the end of windows. I think they can be abused a little bit, but this lad gets rather good, and if we can get him in for the summer, that would be excellent. Grab ourselves a new goalkeeper. Disregard release clause. He only wants £17,000 a week. I'm comfortable with that. That's easy. That is an easy signing right off the bat. A goalkeeper into the club. He'll be here in the summer, and we'll have ourselves a new goalkeeper. Not to replace Gallini. Gallini's been pretty good for us, but we can upgrade on Gallini, and Nubel is an upgrade, and we can do it for free. Why wouldn't you do such a thing? So let's go up. Now, there are a couple of places here where we need a player. Lee is someone I just thought of, or I did think of during the summer. Unfortunately, he did move on to Sheffield, and that is someone we can move away. We've also got a couple of you have mentioned Kovalenko as a good option. This lad I looked at as a free, but not going anywhere. I believe he was also looked at as a free, not going anywhere. Benitez, another one looked at as a free, but we don't need him anymore. And Kovalenko, as I said, is something you guys have offered up. Emerson is another player offered up. Unfortunately, he is on loan. We're going to get rid of him for now. I think, as I said, I didn't want to abuse this, but this is probably a really good one to move on with also. Kovalenko, a cam to bring in over the summer, and he can also play deeper in midfield as well. So that is a good option. Let's go ahead and bring this lad in. 5 years he likes. Rotation is perfect. Disregard release clause. He only wants $25,000 a week. We're going to counter and just remove the bonus. See if he accepts that. And he does. And Kovalenko's in. So we've got two free players we're not doing anymore. No more free. We probably won't do a free player for the rest of this series, I would think, as he goes out the window there. So we've got two players bought in, and they are summer-type players. We still need players for now to help us out in our second-half push toward the top of the table. Not the top of the table. Top four. We'd like to push toward top four. We're going to advance here just a couple of hours. It doesn't look like any bids are coming in. The one bid I'm actually waiting for, if it comes in, would be for Zapata. If it comes in, I'm not so sure it may, but we will have to see. We've got some strikers here just in case. You know, we'll see. What is his release clause? $63 million. There's no way. Moussa Dembele, a lot of money. Belotti, they're all a decent amount of money. $32 million for Osimhen would be all right. Divock Origi out on loan. So it's difficult, though. We could theoretically bring Origi in for free if we wanted. But yeah, so we're in kind of that position. One position we do need help in, left back. And a load of you have mentioned this lad to me. I've never used him, actually. But that looks like we're someone we're going to bring in right now. We're going to attempt to bring him in between 5 and 7 million. Hopefully a bargain. Offer a transfer fee. We'll start at 5. See what they say. They just want a 10% sell-on clause. We're going to counter that. Remove the sell-on clause. Submit the offer again. They want 5.8. I'm comfortable with that. A comfortable price. And Kasace. What a name that. So many C's. Jesus. Kasace. I believe that's how you say it. I would assume that's how you say it. He's currently rotation. Would he be cool with rotation? Excellent. That's good. 73 overall is not too bad for what it is at the moment. 5-year contract. Accept it. Disregard release clause. What does he want in money? How about 6,000 a week? This is kind of... I worry about what he might want. He wants 7,300. That's fine. That's cheap. And we may have ourselves a new left back. He may not exactly be the starter just yet, but that is a good option to have. And it frees up a little bit of space here with Gosens and Castagne, who are both kind of just dealing with that left back spot on their own. So having Kasace ready to roll, that is a good option. And we can also bring one of these two off. So we'll probably pop him onto the bench. Actually, Sportiello can come off. We'll bring Popov on, why not? Having Kasace, actually, Pasalic. That's probably Pasalic. Yeah, we'll go with Pasalic for now. Or Belanova. A right back is something we can also theoretically do. Or winger. Just the winger who can play on both sides is probably a really good option for us right now. We've got players coming in, as we saw. Goalkeeper is something we don't have to worry about. Cam. I think going for another Cam would be a good idea, mainly because Kovalenko can play deeper, and if he can fill up a backup spot in both of those positions, then we're not really in a crazy spot in terms of bringing in a new player. 42 or 4.2 million for Sportiello. That's probably pretty good. We're going to advance. I don't mind moving him on. And we have a goalkeeper in the youth setup that could definitely be of help to us. So it's not like I have a huge issue moving him on. He is the backup for now. All right, so let's go. We've got some buying to do. So we've done our left back. We're looking at midfield. You know, right back could be an option. A lot of you have mentioned Keanu Hover. We'll have to see. What else are we looking at? Midfield. Renato Sanchez. You can play on the right, Renato, as well, but Guimaraes won't move again. Would this be a good option? No, because he's not going anywhere. Nkuku can play striker. That's new. Surely. Vlasic. What about Vlasic? A good player. I don't know if he'll move again. Of course not. Nobody will ever move again. Nobody ever wants to move. We're looking around. He's out on loan, Holshek. He's a good player. Rocca. He just doesn't do it for me in terms of physicals. Gotta be physically dynamic in midfield if we're only gonna play two. What about Mandragora? Not the quickest either. Can we work on that though? He's pretty decent all over the pitch. He grows pretty well. I've got a lot to think about here. But let's try Danielle Maldini. I don't think they'd ever sell. We're going to approach Kiana Hover. I don't know how much they're going to want. I'm willing, you know, to negotiate, of course. But let's see if we can go for Kiana Hover. Have two right backs, both young, both ready to roll. We're just going to start at five. It may be a bit much. Yeah, we probably overpaid, but the problem is that we didn't know, but we also needed to bring in a player there. The problem we're currently dealing with is that everybody's just moved. Everybody we want to deal with has just moved. He just wants to be a prospect. Okay. 5-year deal. Comfortable with that. No release clause, except, Jesus, I almost ended negotiation. That would have been something else. 5 million would end up being a bargain here. But we'll have to see. I don't know what he's on wages-wise either. He's comfortable. Perfect. All right, so £10,000 a week. Not too bad. And now we've helped out our forward areas just a little bit, freeing up Hatsuburo to play right wing full-time now that we have two players who can play right back. 65 overall. I thought he'd be a little bit higher than that. But that's all right. We have options now at right back, though Hover is going to need a bit of training sooner rather than later. Let's jump forward just an hour or so. We've got something in there. That might be the Sportiello deal. Agreement has been made, 4.7 million. Comfortable with that. Accept it. And out the door, Sportiello goes. Not too bad. We still got time here. Crazy. This has been a wild window, but we've got some options still. I dislike how everybody has just moved. Team won't sell this player. He's just moved, Mirenchuk, and I'm pretty sure. Or he hasn't, but I'm pretty sure this one has. Unless I. Maybe he hadn't. And Cuckoo here. I do want to bring in a Cam. My thing is, I kind of want to bring in a Cam who can play a variety of spots. What about you? He's got some pretty decent... I mean, there are obviously ranges there, but he's got some pretty decent ones. Lewis Ferguson. My thing about bringing players from the United Kingdom over to Europe, that doesn't happen too often. And I don't particularly want to go at that just that way. Do we pay 35 million for Nkunku? He's 22. He's only 22. 81 overall. Do I approach to loan? Vlasic. This is a tough window. There are a lot of players here who don't want to move. Or are not going to. It's just join the club kind of thing. I don't know if that's just a silly glitch I'm dealing with, but everybody has just joined. I think what we're going to do is we're going to go midfield and Cam. And I think we're going to stop it there. Fratesi kind of wanted to bring in. Mandragora, though, I believe, is the midfielder we're going to bring in. Italian from the league, of course, at Udinese, has plenty of room to grow. Only 22. I think this could be a good buy. What did they want? They wanted between like 19 and 22 or something like that. Unless I read that wrong. Maybe between 12 and 18 was something. Either way, we're bringing him in. I've messed that up, I think. But I don't think I went way out of the way. I think they wanted between 12 and 18. I just read it wrong toward the end there. I was just reading his age too much and thought 22. Let's see if they'll take rotation. Important, that's fine, that's fine. So always try and get the lower end of that, just so players get unhappy less often. 5-year deal, acceptable. No release clause, except. What does he want for wage? Nobody ever wants to tell me what they want, which is driving me absolutely nuts. Whoa, God, almost a million. We'll try 20K. A 200,000 signing bonus. Alright, so let's counter. Remove the bonus. Submit the offer. £28,000 a week. Not too bad. He's not overly excited about that wage, but that's what he's getting. And he's accepted it. Well, let's take a look what that does to our midfield. Robertone is still here, of course. Mandragora. We can move him onto the bench ahead of Pasalic. And then, do I bring him in ahead of anybody? Maybe he sits behind Malinovsky. I like to have a good player here. The Malinovsky is a good player. Robertone is more dynamic. So maybe Mandragora could sit on the bench for this moment in time, and then obviously that'll grow. We need to grow that pace. 59 is just not going to cut it. I can't quite do anything about it just yet, but I think we want to bring in one more player. We have 31 million to spend. How much wage? 204,000. Do we hit Nkuku's release clause? Can we? God, we're gonna be mighty close. Maybe if the money comes in for Sportiello right now. Right here. Hopefully that's the Sportiello money. An offer for Castagne. Of course, Inter would take forever to do this. Castagne is not going anywhere. So, what was the. How much wage do I have there? 50K. Transfer hub. And cuckoo. Not the quickest to play Cam. See, I always thought he was a deeper midfielder. Maybe that's not someone we deal with right now. £33 million for Miranchuk. Maldini, Ferguson. We also have money that we can theoretically save. Orsolini, another one from Udinese. He's out on loan, though. Out on loan. We have a cam coming. I do want to bring in another cam just so we can have two for what we have right now. I really kind of wanted to bring in Renato Sanchez, but he's just moved on there. His physicals are not good enough to play cam for me either. He's only 18, but those physicals look pretty good. Ball control. See, he's got a lot to work on. I was thinking about Origi. The problem with Origi is that is a free kind of thing. I don't want to deal with that. We are in a bit of a bind here. And Cuckoo's just not the kind of player I would put there at CAM. And these players are out on loan and not going anywhere. Do we look around for some more CAMs possibly? And we'll keep an eye on Maldini, because that's someone one of you mentioned that really caught my eye, but my issue with Maldini is that doesn't seem super realistic at this moment in time. And also, That's mainly it, really. He's also got a lot to do. I kind of want to bring in a player who's ready to roll, kind of, at this moment in time. What are we looking at here? What happened to Alberto? Oh, there he is. Yeah, that's too much money. We don't also have... We can't, like, bring in, like, a crazy good player. Roma. I thought Italian. What if we went to... What about... Hold on. Maybe... Can Yanou Zai play down the middle? I think he can. He's at Arsenal. So, he's not going anywhere, unfortunately. He can play right wing. I know he can play right wing. Is that what Yanou Zai looks like now? Looks like a mugshot. See, this is... We're in a bit of a bind, aren't we? In terms of Cam. We really, really are. Dortmund always have players... Julian Brandt. Too much money. They just bought Gomez. Thorgan Hazard. He can play down the middle too. Now Giovanni Reyna. This is a good little player. I'm gonna scout him and see what happens there. Reyna would be a pretty... He looks like he's gonna be pretty good at least. Or Bayern holding on to here. They don't really have the type of Cam I'm looking for. Coutinho would be pretty cool, wouldn't he? But he's on loan at Bayern, so... But that would be a pretty cool one. Coutinho. Maybe that's something we look at for the summer? Coutinho? My thing with Coutinho is... In game, we can play him right down the middle. I got no problem with that. But, in real life, every team plays him out left, seemingly. Like a winger, Liverpool played him out left, but he cut in at Liverpool. And he wasn't really a left winger. And then Barca bought him and just played him out left like he was Neymar. And that, I think that's a huge issue that's currently going with Coutinho. Teams are just playing him in weird spots. We're having... I don't even know. Oh, you know what would be really cool? Actually, I was thinking about him earlier. What about Oscar? Is he still in China? He is. Short lived in the transfer hub. How cool would Oscar be? Let's see if we can bring Oscar in. Get him out of China. Would he come though? Is Coutinho. Where in the world is Oscar? Did I not just... Oh, see, I did... I accidentally offered a pound earlier. Oh, man, that would be awesome to bring in. I've messed that up. Shame. It was accidental before. See, that would have been a really cool one. I scrolled over Chelsea, and that's exactly what we were looking at. All right, that's exactly what brought that to mind. That's such a shame, because Oscar would be a really cool one. What have they got at Arsenal? Willick. It doesn't tickle my fancy too much. Joseph Willick. Pretty decent, but I don't think he's going to be the player that... Arsenal fans seem to think. And Jurgen, he's supposed to turn out pretty good. Barkley. See, he's an English player I wouldn't bring along. Or I wouldn't think would come across into Europe. English players don't move into Europe very often. That's why it's kind of tough here. I thought about Richarlison for a minute, but... If he wasn't going to Barca, then... Probably not coming to Atalanta, I would think. James Maddison. Tielemans would be a really good signing, of course, but not exactly the signing we would be looking for. Liverpool don't have really any CAMs I can think of. They don't really have too many realistic ones here. City, I'm probably looking too high, but I'm trying to think of CAMs from other places, and I'm not sure any really get me going. Dele Alli, it's Jetson Fernandez, Lamella, Sessegnon, Son. It's tough. It's tough looking around for these kind of positions at the moment. What did we do with Watford for CAM? We did Barco played there. Kana, of course. He was more of a backup. Grealish. A lot of English players, unfortunately. Wolves don't really run a CAM either. And a Bakare. Yeah, they don't really run that. So we're in a spot that is not what I would like it to be. Let's go to Monaco. They are always... Golovin would be cool, but Golovin just moved, right? We'll shortlist him. I think he's just moved, so I don't think he's going anywhere. It's a weird team. And Ndombele. How come he moved after like 6 months? Oh, he's on loan at Mon... What? McTominay? See, how come... He's been there. That's so weird. That is so weird. Oh, what about Depay? Would he leave Leon? Maybe not, but he can play. Oh, he's... That's a lot of money, isn't it, for Depay? Jesus. A lot of money. What were we just at? Leon. Aouar would be amazing, but that's probably a stretch. That Harvey Barnes, Damari Gray, Terrier can play both spots, I'm pretty sure. I'm not 100% on top of that, but I'm pretty positive he can play both spots. So can Rene Adelaide, I think. Marseille, too much checking around. This video is going to be longer than I would have liked, and I didn't even cut it. I'm kind of just rolling with it a bit live, which, you know, sometimes you just got to roll with it and see what you can come up with. They're very thin here. Julian Draxler. Draxler can play on the wing as well. Maybe Draxler's the guy. Draxler, his PSG career hasn't exactly, like, flown away. Maybe he would like to move. We'll see how much money it's going to cost. 24 and 35. That's doable. He can play left wing and striker. He can play all those positions, but they want 40. Yeah, there's no way we can bring Depay in. Golovin, Coutinho. Giovanni Reyna. See, he can play both of those spots. We're going to go for Draxler, I think. I'm thinking about how realistic this could be. I think it could happen. Atalanta are a proper good team. And Draxler, as I said, his career hasn't exactly lit up over there at Paris. They're comfortable with that? Oh, wow. I did not expect that. We're going to see how much money he wants. He's probably on a decent amount of money at Paris. It's going to be difficult. And it's going to be one of those things where he doesn't want to... He's currently on £100,000 a week. Important. He wants to be crucial. Fair enough. Fair enough. Have to give him a couple things here. 5 years. Comfortable. No release clause. Comfortable. What do you want for wage? Please just tell me. No, they're not going to tell me. Okay, so... Let's give him a big one of those. I'm just going to try 70. He's fair. Okay. I was worried about how that would actually end up working. I really was. Mainly because if he wasn't going to tell us, then you never know. But that is a good signing, I think. Oh, it is a good signing. It just is. Who do we take off here? Zapata, I guess. And then we bring him into the team. He can play on the left. Maybe. Do we start him out there on the left? I'm going to start him out there on the left, and I am going to check one more player before we end this video. We have 9 million in the bank. 8 million, I lied. But there's money there. And I'm going to try Giovanni Reyna and see what this is like. Never mind, I lied. It's not going anywhere, Reyna. So I guess not. So I guess we'll end it there. We're going to try for Maldini then. That's all they want. I don't know how good Maldini gets. I don't even know if he gets any good, but he'd be a pretty cool player to have in. And he can be an emergency kind of guy before Kovalenko comes anyway. I'm just going to offer 7 and get this over with. Let's see what Maldini will negotiate. I've reached maximum squad size? I really have to release someone? What? Oh, well, you know what? Let's just terminate Pasalic's loan. I'm not worried about that. He hasn't played at all. And it's January. I should be able to terminate it, but I didn't think I'd reach maximum squad size. Does that include all these players here that are out on loan? I guess they're going to come back and there are going to be some problems to deal with. Okay, so terminate loan. Yes. Now let's go after Maldini and bring him in. So if that's going to be if that's what's going to happen, this is going to be a bit of an issue, isn't it? Maldini, negotiate. Okay, so we can bring him in now. I'm not sure how good he gets, Maldini, so we'll have to take a look, but one of you had offered him up. He is obviously the son of a great. 5 years. But if that's the issue, I hope the squad size limit is because of all those players out on loan. If it isn't, then we're going to have a lot of dealing to do. We're gonna have a lot of dealing to do next time round. We'll just offer a 5. No signing bonus. Let's look at Maldini. I'm not sure anything about him. This is just an emergency kind of buy, just in case, I think. Yeah, 62. He is 18, so there's obviously a lot to work on, but you know, we'll see what happens going forward. But yes, a pretty good window, I think. We had to make changes. We've bought right backs in, 2 of them, a starter, of course. Move Hatteburg forward. We bought Draxler in, who can play down the middle, out left. Mandragora has come in as well, can play across the middle, of course. Kaseche at left back. And then, is that it? That's pretty good. Maldini, of course, is in, and we've got a lot of players that we're looking at for the future. So, you know, I think we've done pretty good there. We've got some money left over come summertime, and not too bad. Let's take a look at the top deals before we end this guy. Robertson went to Real Madrid. Schüle went to Liverpool. Umtiti to Paris. Busquets to Juve. That's a very Juve kind of signing. Aubameyang to Real Madrid. Pogba to Barca. Valverde to Leipzig, that's a good signing. Royce to Real Madrid. Carvajal to Juve, another Juve type of signing. Aspas to Chelsea, that's a bit weird at 32. Vardy to Arsenal. That transfer came up in real life after Arsenal bid for him. He wouldn't fit at Arsenal, it'd be a waste of time. Gomez, of course, 50 million, that's pretty good money. Van de Beek to Inter. Jeez, I split those two up. Brozovic to Tottenham. Martial to Juve. Lacazette. Arsenal sold off all their strikers. No wonder they bought Vardy. And Guerrero went to Roma. We looked at him to get him in for free, but didn't happen. Kramaric to Inter. Rugani. Bernadeschi out at Juve. Anything weird? Ndidi to Juve. Juve have had a busy window. Mertens to Leverkusen. Azpilicueta to Real Madrid have had a crazy one as well. And Naki Williams, two strikers here to Leipzig. Did Werner move on? Rodrigo to Dortmund. That seems like a realistic one, that. Wendell, Kimpembe to Valencia. So a lot of signings here. Bentancur to Newcastle. That's a coup for Newcastle. We'll see with Newcastle. They're going to have some money, I think. Joseph Martinez, another player we looked at, off to Roma. Neres to Arsenal. McTominay, it's an odd one. Matip to Dortmund. Not bad. A wild window. Harry Winks is off. David Silva, 30 million. He'll be leaving on a free, but... did the money ever come in for Sportiello? Is that even going to happen? A lot of scout reports just came in, right? Or is that youth stuff? Oh, yeah, I guess not. Broken down. He couldn't reach anything. His loan expired. Transfer offer came in for him. We'll hold on to these till next time round. And, yeah, so this video is... wow, I did not think it'd be this long. That is my fault. I apologize. Next episode, we'll get a couple games in. Genoa, Fiorentina, maybe Torino, depending on what, when, why, how things go around. But we're ready to challenge the top four in the second half here. Not February, but March is a big month. Champions League football and the Napoli-Lazio semifinal, the Copa. It's a lot to come, guys. But I hope you've stayed too. Let me know if you've actually stayed all the way to the end, right? Something in the comments like I stayed to the end or whatever it may be. Let me know if you actually went through all this. But for now, guys, that's it. Hope you've enjoyed, and peace.